reorganization 2014 ordinance is against the spirit of the constitution.
Yes.
Madam.
Why all of you are coming? I don't understand.
Hey, we are all against Malabaram. We are all against Malabaram.
Yes, Mr. Vinod Kumar.
The AP Reorganization Act 2014
yes.
was already notified on 1st March 2014.
Yes.
So the state of Telangana was formed on 1st March 2014, though the notified date was mentioned as 2nd June. This government has brought this ordinance on 29th
please,
May.
Please, 1 minute. Please go to your seat. Your member is speaking. No, you don't want to hear him. What all you? He is speaking, no? I have given him to speak. He is opposing whatever it is. Let him speak.
Madam,
please go to your seat.
I have moved the statutory resolution,
yes.
whereas our party is opposing for the
yes.
debate of the
yes.
discussion of the bill in this house, madam, because the ordinance itself is against the spirit of the constitution.
Yes.
They can't issue the ordinance after the state is formed. They have to follow the Article 3 as per the constitution
yes.
in order
first,
to alter the boundaries
you
of a state.
Go to your seat.
So
your
now,
member is speaking.
Let the statutory resolution be discussed first.
Saying?
It should not be clubbed. My contention is, let
yes.
the statutory resolution be discussed first.
Yes.
You can't club the bill and the statutory resolution at a time. That's my contention.
Yes.
Let the statutory resolution be discussed first, then only we will discuss the bill. Because I have a case. The state of Telangana was formed on 1st March 2014 as per the gazette and notification issued by His Excellency the President of India. So on 29th May, the government can't bring an ordinance. In order to alter the boundaries of a state, they have to follow Article 3 of the Constitution. The President has to recommend the bill into the House after only eliciting the views of the respective state legislature. So the government has not elicited the views of the state legislature of Telangana as well as the state of Andhra Pradesh. Thus, I want a discussion on statutory rule resolution first, then only on the list of users.
No.
Thus, I request a discussion on the statutory resolution.
No,
my request to the Honorable Chair is you can't club the bill as well as the statutory resolution at a time. Thank you.
Sorry, as per convention, we have clubbed these two attempts, no? The two attempts have been clubbed. So now you have raised your statutory resolution. Now you can speak on the bill. That's all. If you don't want to speak,
can alter the state. Let all the parliamentarians know
yes.
whether a government can alter the state, whether the government can alter the boundaries of a state by bringing an ordinance. Let all parliamentarians know it. Let all states know it. Whether can the boundaries of the state can be altered by way of ordinance. This is my contention. Can ordinance bring
no,
the alteration?
Nothing going on record. You please, sir. Mr. Reddy. Yes.
A serious question.
Yes. No, nothing is going on record. Mr. Reddy, yes, please. No point of order now this time. Yes. No. Under what rule? Which rule you are quoting?
23(2) of the Constitution.
What?
Madam,
which rule
you
are quoting?
Please. Listen to me, 123.
No, 123.
2 of the Constitution of India.
Yeah.
Madam, see, an ordinance promulgated under this article shall have the same force and effect. Ordinance shall be laid before both houses of parliament
yeah.
and shall cease to operate at the expiration of 6 weeks.
Yes.
From the reassembly of parliament
yes.
or if before the expiration of that period resolution disapproving it are passed by both houses upon the passing of second of these resolutions. So this is the procedure as far as ordinance are concerned.
Yes.
But what the Honorable Member Vinod Kumar has mentioned is an even more important point, that how are states to be formed? Article 3 of the Constitution says formation of new states and alteration of areas, boundaries or names of existing states. Parliament may by law form a new state, etc. Increase the area of any state. C. diminish the area of any state, provided that no bill for the purpose shall be introduced in either House of Parliament except on the recommendation of the President, and unless where the proposal contained in the bill affects the area's boundaries or name of any of the state, the bill has been referred to the President, to the legislature of that state. So the Article 3 of the Constitution, has the President's recommendation been received for altering the boundary of the state? So A, you have to discuss the statutory resolution separately, and then the minister has to clarify whether the recommendation of the President with regard to the bill has been received. It is very unfortunate that without obtaining the sanction, without obtaining the approval of the Telangana government and the Odisha government, the government has gone ahead and issued, promulgated an ordinance. This is bad in law. What is being done will be bad in law, will be challenged in the Supreme Court. Madam, let us not create precedents where the Constitution is violated.
Please, no, I am replying to the objection by Vinod Kumar. Mr. Honourable Members, statutory resolutions and bills to replace ordinances have been discussed together before also. So to save the time of the House, there is no rule which bars to combining all these things, do two things. No. And that's why I said item number 11 and 12 will go together. So please. No,
the ordinance was issued.
I have already, we can
on
combine it, and
May.
We have combined it. If you want to speak, you can speak on the bill itself. Statutory resolution.
No, I can't talk on the bill, madam. My contention is the bill is against the, they have introduced the bill against the spirit of the Constitution. On the first day, they raised a question that they did not get the recommendation of the President. Then the Honorable Home Minister had said in the House that as they could not get the recommendation of the President, they introduced on Tuesday. So on they deferred it on Monday. And my contention is the President has not sought or elicited the views of the respective state legislature to introduce a bill of such a nature which is altering the boundaries of a state. I mean, here they are going to alter the boundaries of two states, that is the state of Telangana as the state of Andhra Pradesh. So my contention is the bill doesn't deserve to be discussed in the House because it doesn't have the competence. It doesn't have competence to be introduced in this House. So constitutionally, it doesn't have competence to be introduced. Let the Home Minister and let the Prime Minister defer the bill today and let them come on Monday after discussing in detail.
Honorable Ma'am, yeah, please sit down now. Sit. You don't want my ruling or what? You please sit down here. Honorable Member, Sri Saugat Rai and Mr. Vinod Kumar also has contended that the Andhra Pradesh Reorganization Amendment Bill 2014 has been introduced in Lok Sabha without referring it to concerned state legislature in violation of Article 3 of the Constitution. Okay? Honorable Members, the bill has already been introduced. The issue whether or not the bill has been introduced in violation of Article 3 requires interpretation of the provision of the Constitution. Honorable Members would appreciate that interpretation of the provisions of the Constitution is primarily the responsibility of the courts of law. Also, the point raised does not relate to regulating the business of the House. I therefore rule out the point of order and ask Mr. Gutha Shekhar Reddy. Mr. Gutha Shekhar Reddy, do you want to speak?